Hello, I'm John Fender. I'm Professor of Macroeconomics at the University of Birmingham, and I'm going to say something about the economic consequences of Brexit if we, you know, do decide to leave the economic union. But I thought I'd say something about its effect on trade, and also I talk a little bit about regulation. Now, trade is really important. We're a trading nation, we've been a trading nation for hundreds of years, and trade is really crucial for our prosperity. So a really important question is how the decision to leave the European Union would affect our trade. Now, at the moment, as a member of the European Union, what we have is in fact pretty good. We have access to this large single market of over 500 million people. We have say over the rules and regulations of the single market, and we have access via the EU's preferential trade deals to trade with a lot of other countries on preferential on a preferential basis. So this is pretty good, quite frankly. Now, how would a decision to Brexit change this? Well, one answer is that we really don't know, because we really don't know what sort of trade deals or what arrangements will be made if we do exit. We can make a few guesses. Our relationship, our future trade relationship with the EU will, of course, be very important. Now, laid down in the Lisbon Treaty, there's a two-year period of negotiation. Now, it's not clear whether we'll emerge from that with a fully fledged trade deal with the EU. My guess is that we won't. We'll emerge with some sort of interim deal, and the details of a longer-lasting trade deal will have to be sort of fleshed out over the next few years. So it'll probably be some time before we have a replacement trade deal with the EU. I'd have thought the guess would be that it would be inferior to what we'd have at the moment. And then there's also the question of preferential trade deals. The EU has preferential trade deals with 53 countries at the moment. Now, when we leave the EU, or if we leave the EU, these trade deals would lapse and we'd have to negotiate them again. We'd have to negotiate other trade deals as well. But are there other reasons why Brexit might be advantageous? Now, some of the campaigners for Brexit have said, oh, there's all this sort of awful EU regulation, all this red tape, which really handicaps our businesses. Now, you know, a few months ago when I became interested or more interested in this topic, I, you know, started searching around, trying to find examples. What are examples of this really horrendous regulation and red tape that the EU inflicts on us? And quite frankly, I did find it, you know, quite difficult. But, you know, I have persisted and, you know, I found a few examples of onerous regulations or regulations which are really we'd like to get rid of. It seems that the sort of worst regulation, or at least the regulation that most people complain about, is the Working Time Directive. Now, what does that imply? Well, it imposes a maximum working week of 48 hours. Right? Now, one can opt out of it, and many employees do. Now, is this a really serious, harmful form of regulation? Well, it has caused some problems, I believe, particularly in the National Health Service. There were some quite considerable problems in adapting to this. But, you know, by and large, I really find it difficult to believe that something like this is particularly harmful. And some people would, in fact, take the view that, you know, it's a good thing that one can't be forced to work for more than 48 hours. So, as far as regulation is concerned, I'd say, well, you know, some EU regulation is harmful. And perhaps an advantage of Brexit is that we could get rid of this regulation, but we must realise, you know, we have to have regulation. We have to have regulation to protect consumers, to protect the environment, and to protect workers. We'd have regulation if we left, and I don't think we're particularly good at regulating ourselves. You know, one can think of plenty of stupid regulations which we've inflicted on ourselves. And perhaps the worst, or the one that comes to mind, is various types of planning restrictions, which are perhaps responsible for the sort of housing crisis we have at the moment. So my take is that on regulation is that perhaps we could get rid of some harmful EU regulation, but I don't think by and large EU regulation is a major problem as far as our economy is concerned at the moment. If we do decide to leave the EU on Thursday, then on Friday I'd expect the markets would react quite strongly. I'd expect there'd be a large depreciation of the exchange rate and a large fall in the stock market. Over the following few months, there'd be considerable uncertainty. I'd expect perhaps a lot of financial sector firms would reduce their employment in the UK. There'd be a fall in foreign direct investment and so forth. There'd be a period of economic instability that could well be exacerbated by political instability, because one would expect that David Cameron would resign very soon after a Brexit vote. I don't see any way in which he could continue. So there's going to be a period of several months during which the Conservatives will have to sort out their leadership issue, and we won't know in that period what's going to happen. So there are going to be a lot of people wanting to know, a lot of people, a lot of businesses wanting to know, thinking, you know, I'm going to want to export to the EU. Am I going to have to pay tariffs in 2 or 3 years' time? And they won't have an answer to that question, and it'll be some time before the uncertainty is resolved. So I would expect a period of economic and political turmoil in the months after a Brexit vote. It won't be pleasant, and I really hope I don't find out.